So, how are cervical polyps diagnosed? Well, as most patients with cervical polyps don't have any symptoms, they're frequently found during procedures where the cervix is visualized, such as during cervical screening or routine pelvic examination. Incidentally, so if you do have the symptoms listed earlier, your doctor would perform an internal examination which involves using a tool called a speculum, which helps to separate the walls of the vagina to clearly visualize the cervix to look for any polyps. Once they're found, the treatment is usually to remove them, and the process of removal depends on the size, type, location, visibility, and the number of polyps. Most are done as an outpatient procedure, so the smaller polyps can be removed quite easily using a forceps to twist and pull them off. This may lead to minimal bleeding and a mild cramp-like discomfort. Whilst larger polyps are removed using a heated wired loop, which may cause heavy bleeding and more pronounced abdominal discomfort. But please be reassured that local anesthetic is often used, and you'd always be encouraged to take some painkillers to ease the pain. The procedure would never be done without your consent. Occasionally, you may need to have a procedure done under general anesthesia, where a camera called a hysteroscope is inserted into the cervix to better visualize the endocervical polyps and remove them. Samples are then sent off to the lab to analyze, and depending on the results, you may have further treatment or your cervix most likely would be monitored routinely. It's important to remember that in some instances, the doctor may opt to monitor cervical polyps instead of removing them. This is patient dependent and is usually the case if the polyps are quite small and do not cause any symptoms at all. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to click that subscribe button and turn those notifications on, and I will see you on the next video. Bye!